through marriage, two people become one in God's sight. Scripture teaches that this union is God's ideal plan for relationship and the chosen symbol for His love for us in Jesus Christ. Marriage is, therefore, a unique and special occasion, and it is our privilege today to celebrate that occasion with David and Alisha. Who gives this woman to be married?
Her mother and I.
Mom's going to. Okay. She's going to fix my purse.
It's okay. We got you.
You may be seated.
You're comfortable. Yeah.
Yeah.
We're good.
Love is an amazing thing. It's emotion, conviction, action, all rolled into one. It's hard to define, but impossible to ignore. Love opens our hearts and expands our capacity to live together. It gives us hope and determination, wholeness and happiness. Love shows us the possibilities and accomplishes in us what nothing else can do. And that's because love is why we're here. The Bible teaches us that we are here to love and be loved. And without love, we are nothing. The Apostle Paul puts it this way: if I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but do not have love, I'm just making noise. If I have the gift of prophecy, if I know all mysteries, if I have knowledge, if I have such great faith that I can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. Now, those are strong words, and we could bring them to the modern world a little bit. If I have great career, if I have education, if I have success, but do not have love, I am nothing. Love is why we're here. Supremely, we experience that love in Jesus Christ, but we also have the privilege of discovering that love in each other, and that is why we've gathered today. To finish Paul's words, love is patient and kind. It is not jealous or arrogant or proud or rude. Love is not easily offended and keeps no record of wrongs. It despises injustice and rejoices when the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, always hopes, and endures every circumstance. Love lasts forever. David and Alisha, our prayer for you today is that love will bind you together, sustain you through difficult times, and inspire you to be more together than you could ever be apart. Would you join us as we pray? Father, I thank you for this happy occasion. I thank you for David and Alisha, who are special to us, and I know to you as well. Father, I thank you for guiding their lives and directing them together to this moment. I pray that you will bind them and their family together. I pray that you will keep them strong, provide for them, protect them, and guide them for your purpose. I thank you today for the Lord Jesus, whose love makes this all possible. And in his name I pray, amen.
Amen.
Okay. Yes, I do. Okay. Do you, David, take Alisha to be your wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, forsaking all others, till death do you part?
I do.
Do you, Alisha, take David to be your husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, forsaking all others, till death do you part?
I do.
From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment,
Broken circle. The wedding ring is a simple yet powerful example, symbol of unending love and covenant commitment. David, if you will please place Alicia's ring on her finger and then repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
I pledge my love to you.
Alisha, if you'll please place David's ring on his finger and then repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
I pledge my love to you.
By the authority vested in me by God and by the laws of this state, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What therefore God has joined together, let no one separate. David, you may kiss your bride. Woo! Friends and family, it is my great honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. David Adelman.